WYFF News 4, live local breaking news at 6.
Good evening, I'm Carol Goldsmith.
And I'm Michael Cogdill. Missing teenagers in safe hands tonight thanks to a very observant truck driver.
The 13-year-old girl from North Carolina disappeared Monday with a man she met online. Deputies tracked them down in the upstate today. News 4's John Eby talked to that truck driver this afternoon. John, how did he recognize them?
Well, he said he was driving up through the area where the girl is from yesterday, and he heard the Amber Alert come over the radio. And today, for some reason, that license plate number on the car just stuck in his head. Now, some background on the case. On Monday, Alexandria Cagle went missing. She's from Alamance, North Carolina. Deputies say she has a serious medical condition that requires her to take daily medication. Investigators say she left the home with this man, 18-year-old Tyler Ross Cole. He's from West Virginia. Deputies say a few $1,000 disappeared from Cagle's home along with Alexandria. So Cole is charged with kidnapping, felonious larceny, and contributing to the delinquency of a minor. This afternoon around 1:30, a tow truck driver was driving on I-85 near Greer when he saw a car that matched the description of the Amber Alert. He checked the license plate number. Sure enough, it was a match. So he called 911 and followed the car until deputies could arrive. He said it's just a reminder to him never to ignore those Amber Alerts.
This one just sunk in for some reason. There's no reason. I don't understand why, but pay attention to them. And if there's anything I can say, they pay off. In this case, for sure, the Amber Alert's what is the reason I'm here, you're here, and she's going back home safe.
Now, deputies say Cagle is in good condition. She's here at the Spartanburg County Law Enforcement Center, still talking to deputies. Cole is at the Spartanburg County Detention Center, waiting to be picked up and taken back into custody in Alamance County. Tonight at 11, we got the blow-by-blow from that truck driver of how he tracked down that car. He tells us about how Cole, the driver, tried to get away from him. He also pointed out something that the young man was wearing that seemed kind of fishy. I have more on that tonight at 11. John Eby, WYFF News 4, live in Spartanburg County.
Well, look for it, John. Thank you. A 22-year-old woman was shot in the face this morning, and not only did she survive, somehow she managed to walk half